Welcome everyone to this online expand class. So if you're joining me at home today, thank you, and I'm happy that you're here. It's difficult to maintain a sense of community during these hard times, but I'm glad to be here to share something with you, and hopefully you can take something out of it. I'm glad you're here with me. So we're actually going to start today by standing at the top of the mat. So you can bring your toes and heels together. Start by drawing the navel to the spine, lengthen the tailbone down in between the heels. You can draw up on the kneecaps. Imagine rolling the shoulders back and down away from the ears, chin parallel with the floor. And here you can start to connect with the breath and with the body. Try to elongate your inhales. And as you exhale, imagine grounding down through the feet. So inhale, you can create length through the crown of the head and feel this elevating, uplifting sensation. And as you exhale, press the feet down into the floor, full contact. On your next inhale, you're going to begin to circle, sweep the arms up, slightly spin the pinkies in towards each other. Really imagine reaching the fingertips up to the ceiling. Exhale, bring the palms down to the sides. Let's do this two more times. Inhale, sweep the hands up. If you feel ready, you can always press the palms and look up in between the thumbs. Exhale, hands down to the sides. Last one, inhale, sweeping the arms up. Just kind of warming up the shoulders a little bit. Exhale, bring the hands down to the sides. Now on your next inhale, sweep the hands up. You can press the palms. Exhale, begin to soften through the knees, hinge at the hips. We're going to dive into our first forward fold. When you get to your forward fold, you can bend the knees a couple times back and forth. And shake the head, yes and no. Try to make sure the neck and the jaw are relaxed here. And then you can grab for opposite elbows and just hang heavy. You can softly bend the knees and drape your upper body on top of the thighs. You can sway around a little bit. Try not to hold in the jaw. And just like letting the gentle weight of your elbows draw you a little closer downward, creating some traction in the spine. Begin to release the elbows. Place the hands on your shins. Inhale, unroll spine, first half lift. You can press the palms into the legs, draw the heart in between the heads of the shoulders, chin is away from the chest. Exhale, forward fold. Two more, inhale, half lift. Nice long back, exhale. Forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Now ground through the feet on an inhale, circle, sweep the arms, come up to standing. You can press the palms, draw the kneecaps, look up. Exhale, you can swan dive down into your forward fold, or the hands can come through prayer out in front of you. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Press through the feet, inhale, circle, sweep the arms, come all the way up. Exhale, dive into your forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. We'll do one more together. Inhale, circle, sweep the arms, come all the way up. Really reach for the sky. And exhale, dive into your forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. So plant the hands at the top of the mat. You're going to step your feet back into an upward push-up plank. Try to make sure your hands are shoulder width distance. And we're going to do three Chaturanga Dandasanas. So just come onto your knees for the first one so we can set it up. Imagine puffing up your upper back a little bit so you don't want to collapse into the shoulder blades. Imagine protraction. Press the shoulder blades away from each other. Chin is away from the chest. Draw the navel in, a little bit hollow body action going on. So take an inhale into the upper back. And as you exhale, you'll lower down halfway. Elbows are into the ribs. Collarbones are broad. Inhale, press yourself back up. If you'd like to come off your knees for the last two, go for it. I'll stay on my knees. So take an inhale, press yourself up. Exhale, lower down halfway. Inhale, press yourself back up. Last one, exhale, lower down halfway. Inhale, press yourself up.
Now, as you exhale, start to slowly lower down all the way. See if you can touch your belly and thighs at the same time. Release your toes out long behind you. Keep your hands planted underneath the heads of the shoulders. Press the tops of the feet down on the mat so your legs zip up. Lengthen your tailbone down in between the heels. Shoulders back and down away from the ears. Take an inhale, lift up for baby cobra. So you're barely lifting the chest off the floor. Keep pressing all 10 toenails down. You can even let the hands hover a little bit here. Really draw back on the elbows. Exhale, release. Realign with the hands. Press your feet down, press your hips down. Shoulders back and down away from the ears. Take an inhale, peel the chest off the mat. This time start to slightly straighten the arms for full cobra, Bhujangasana. On your next exhale, come back down to the floor. We're gonna set up for upward facing dog neck, so tuck the toes underneath the heels. Lift yourself up about an inch or two off the mat. You're gonna roll over the tops of the feet. Shoulders back and down away from the ears. Strong, active arms here. The thighs will hover, but keep pressing your tailbone down to the floor. Draw the navel in. And then on your next exhale, roll over the tops of the feet. The hips can come up and back into downward facing dog and just walk the dog out. You can pedal the feet, bend the knees, sway the hips around. It's kind of getting familiar with this posture. But as you start to set up for a strong downward facing dog, think strong, active arms. You can press through the first and second knuckle mounds of the hands. Spin the biceps in towards your ears so your upper back is nice and broad. And we want to go for a nice long back here, so you can have the heels slightly lifted and knees slightly bent to stick the tail straight up to the ceiling. Take an inhale, look up in between the hands. As you exhale, you can step your feet in between the hands, feet together. Inhale into your half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Finding the ground underneath your feet. Inhale, circle, sweep the arms, come all the way up. Exhale, dive into your forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Plant your hands, step your feet back into an upward push-up plank. And we're gonna take our first flow. So as you exhale, lower down halfway into your chaturanga, your yogi push-up. Inhale, back bend. Either baby cobra, full cobra, or upward facing dog. Exhale, hips up and back, downward facing dog. Take an inhale, lift your right leg up. You can circle the ankle out, spread the toes, warming up the foot a little bit. Keep pressing through the palms and through the fingers. You can even bend the knee, take a couple little warm up circles for the hip joint. Now inhale, lift the right leg out long behind you. And as you exhale, shift forward in your plank, knee to nose. Two more times, inhale, the leg out long, down dog split. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, the right leg out long. Exhale, knee to nose. Now inhale, the right leg back out long. And as you exhale, step the right foot in between the hands. You can bring the left knee down onto the mat and release the left toes. You might find the fit of the right knee into your right armpit. Knees traveling over the right ankle. Keep the left palm planted underneath your left shoulder. With an inhale, sweep the right hand up. Really roll the left shoulder underneath the right. You can come up onto your left fingertips for more space if you need it. Take one more breath. Exhale, sweep the right hand back down. Inhale, you can come up onto the fingertips, look forward. On an exhale, start to straighten your right leg, flex the toes for a half split. You can stay up sitting nice and high, or you can bow the forehead to the shin. And keep flexing through the right toes. You'll feel the stretch more into the back of the calf, maybe up all the way through the hamstring. Begin to shift your weight back forward. Plant the right foot. Tuck the left toes underneath the heel. Lift the knee up. Zip the legs up nice and tight. And with an inhale, rise up. High crescent lunge. So we're going to do some stationary lunges here. So take an inhale, reach to the fingertips. Exhale, lower the left knee down. Hover it off the floor. Inhale, press it back up. Two more. Exhale, lower the knee down. Try to hover it. Don't touch the floor. Inhale, press it back up. Last one. Exhale, lower it down. Now inhale, press it back up, really draw up on the left kneecap. Take an inhale, reach the fingertips up. And as you exhale, bring the left arm forward and the right arm back. Maybe try looking past the right thumb. Keep pressing the hips forward, you're just twisting through the upper body.
Take an inhale and reach. Exhale, sweep the right hand back forward. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, sweep the hands down to the mat. Step the right foot back to meet the left. Take a flow. And then we'll all meet back together in downward facing dog. Hips are up nice and high. Draw the low ribs in. Strong, active arms. So what we do on the right, we gotta do on the left. So with an inhale, lift the left leg up. You can circle the ankle out. Spread the toes, maybe even bend the left knee and warm the hip joint up. Each side will feel a little bit different. Just know that's normal. Now inhale the left leg out long behind you. Exhale, shift forward in your plank. Knee to nose. Two more. Inhale. Left leg out long. Exhale. Knee to nose. Last one. Inhale, get it nice and long. Exhale. Knee to nose. Inhale, the left leg back out long behind you. And as you exhale, step the left foot in between the hands. Bring the right knee down onto the mat. Release the right toes. So you can find the fit of your knee into the armpit. Left knee over the left ankle. Right hand planted underneath the right shoulder. Inhale, sweep the left fingertips up. You can always come up onto the right fingertips for more space. Draw the navel in as you twist. Take a breath. Exhale, begin to sweep the left hand back down. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, straighten the left leg, flex the left toes, half split. And then you can bow the forehead to the knee if you like. Begin to bring your weight back forward, plant the left foot, tuck the right toes underneath the heel, lift the knee up off the mat. Now zip the legs up, inhale, rise into your high lunge. So find your high lunge, lengthen the tailbone down, draw the navel in. We're gonna do our stationary lunges. Take an inhale, reach up. Exhale, lower the right knee down, let it hover. Inhale, press it back up. Exhale, lower the right knee down. Inhale, press it back up. Last one, exhale, lower the right knee down. Now inhale, press the knee back up into your high lunge. On your next exhale, right arm forward, left arm back. Maybe try looking at the left thumb with your right eye so you can wink at your own hand. Take an inhale. Exhale, sweep the left hand back forward. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, plant both hands at the top of the mat. Step the left foot back to meet your right. Take a flow. Remember, you can always modify the flow whenever you need to. So inhale, look up in between the hands. As you exhale, step up, float the feet up between the hands. Bring the feet together. Inhale, look ahead of you. Exhale, forward fold. Now bend the knees, sit the hips behind you, sweep the arms up for Utkatasana. Try to really deepen the hip creases here, lift the upper body away from the legs. Keep pressing all 10 toes down, but the weight is over the heels. So take a breath, reach up. Exhale, dive into your forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold, plant the hands. You can step hop or float your feet back. And take your vinyasa flow, your flow it out, hustle and flow. All coming back into downward facing dog. So from your downward facing dog, shift forward into your plank and then bring the knees onto the floor. Hands underneath the shoulders, knees under the hips. Take yourself through some cat-cow tilts. As you inhale, you'll lengthen the belly to the floor. Exhale, round the spine to the ceiling. Inhale, imagine opening the heart up to the sky. Drop the belly. Exhale, chin to sternum, tuck the tail. A couple more times. Coming back into your tabletop position, ground through the right palm. With an inhale, you're gonna sweep the left fingertips up to the ceiling. And as you exhale, thread the needle, lay the left shoulder down on the floor. You can stay here. Maybe you reach the right fingertips above the ear.
If you want it to be a little more intense, you can always straighten the right leg to bring a little more weight into your left shoulder. And if you want it more still, you can try to hover the foot off the floor. Take a breath. Exhale, gather everything back to center. Repress the right palm next to your cheek. With an inhale, you're gonna unravel, sweep the left hand back up. Exhale, plant the left hand under the shoulder. We're gonna do the other side now. So with an inhale, sweep the right fingertips up. Exhale, lay the right shoulder onto the floor. So just be mindful that each side might be a little different. You might need something different on this side. So you can keep the left hand by the cheek. You can always reach above your ear. And you can always straighten the left leg if you need a little bit more. And if you're feeling a little brave, you can try to lift the left foot off the floor. Take an inhale. Exhale, begin to bring everything back to center. Press the left hand back next to your cheek. Inhale, sweep the right hand back up. Exhale, you can set it down. So now we're gonna set up for a lizard pose. So from your tabletop position, just step the right foot on the outside of the right hand. You can kind of scooch your left knee away from you. So this might be intense for you. So you can stay here. Maybe you roll onto the outer edge of the right foot and press the right knee away from you. And then if you want a little bit more, you can come down onto the forearms. You can feel free to rock around a little bit. Kind of massage in your own hip muscles. And try to breathe into the hip. Start to come back up on the hands. You can bring the right foot back down to the mat. Plant your hands under the shoulders, lift the left knee up off the mat. You can step the right foot back to meet your left. And then the left foot's gonna step on the outside of the left hand. You can bring the right knee down. So each hip will definitely feel different. My left hip is always a little bit tighter than my right. So just kind of be mindful and be aware of what's going on with your body. So you can stay up high on the hands. You can press the left knee away from you, rolling onto the outer edge of your left foot. This might be intense for you enough, or you can come down onto the forearms. Feel free to rock your weight around a little bit, kind of massaging your hip muscles. And slow the breath down. Start to make your way back up. You can bring the hands underneath the heads of the shoulders. Lift the right knee up off the mat. You can step the left foot back to meet your right and flow it out. Coming back in downward facing dog. So one way or another, you're gonna come to sitting on the floor with your legs out in front of you. So you can just sit down, or if you're practicing your hop throughs, now's the time. So come to sitting on the floor. Find your sit bones underneath you. Legs are out long in front of you. You can flex the toes to the upper body. Take an inhale and sweep the hands up. Exhale, you can dive and reach for the feet. Inhale, imagine half lift, get a little more length out of the spine. Exhale, you can bow down. You can take any grip you like on the feet, maybe no grip at all. One more deep inhale in. Exhale, let it all go. Begin to rise back up to standing. You can scoot your butt up to the top of the mat. Grab for the backs of the legs. Start to take some rocks and rolls onto your mat. Giving the spine a massage. You can also rock side to side. Maybe make some circles around the lumbar spine. And we're gonna set up for a couple back bends. So plant your feet next to your hips, about hips width distance. Make sure your feet are facing directly forward. Ground the backs of the arms into the floor, and then bend at the elbows.
Press through all four corners of each foot. On an inhale, lift the hips up. See if you can lift the hips as high as your hands here. Squeeze the glutes. Imagine drawing the heels closer to the shoulders. And maintain length from the back of the neck. So from here, if you'd like, you can keep the hands where they are. Maybe you interlace your fingers underneath you to really walk the shoulder blades in close to each other. One more breath here. And as you exhale, slowly lower the hips down. Hug the knees into the chest, and you can tuck the chin. Give yourself a big hug. Now keep the right knee hugged in toward the right armpit. Let the left leg lay out long. With an inhale, give the right knee a nice squeeze. And as you exhale, you can start to bring the right knee over to the left side of your mat for a supine twist. Your right arm can extend out next to you. Try to stay heavy in your right shoulder as you gently draw the right knee across the body. Maybe look past your right shoulder. One more breath here. Exhale, come back to center. Give the knee a nice squeeze and swap it out. Let the right leg lay out long. Hug the left knee in towards the left armpit. Give it a hug. Take a breath. And as you exhale, bring the left knee over to the right side of the mat. You can extend the left arm out next to you. You might need to scooch the bottom hip a little bit deeper underneath you as you twist. Stay heavy in the left shoulder. And as you exhale, the navel will gently fall to the spine. One more breath. Exhale, start to come back to center. You can give the left leg a nice squeeze. And then we're gonna make our way into Shavasana. Nice, quick, easy practice. You can always use this as a fairly easy warm-up for a longer practice. You can always intensify it. But as you make your way into Shavasana, take a little mental inventory of the body to see if you're still holding anywhere. It's always nice to start from the ground up, so think about your feet for a second. You might wiggle the feet out, see if you're still holding. You can let go of the breath if you haven't already. Have your palms facing the ceiling and the shoulders will just melt away from you. Give yourself some appreciation for the work you just put in. You can gently start to relax the space in between the eyebrows and relax the jaw. I'm very happy that I get to share my personal practice with you. And I hope you took something away from this. You may rest in Shavasana for as long as you need to. And I hope to see you all again very soon. Thank you.
Aced it.